Well, I love her, but I love to fish. I spend all day out on this lake, and hell is all I catch. But today she met me at the door, said I would have to choose. And if I hit that fishing hole today,
how big is it?
Packing all her things and she be gone by noon. Well, I'm gonna miss her.
You got him hooked?
I get home. Right now I'm on this lake shore.
You caught that one on a walleye, huh?
Sitting in the sun, I'm sure.
That's awesome. Let me come and take a picture of it.
When I walk through that door tonight, yeah, I'm gonna miss her. Oh, looky there, I've got a bite. All
throw it.
He wants it.
Video camera?
I think so, yeah. I do. Well, I love her, but I love to fish. I spend all day out on this lake, and hell is all I catch. But today she met me at the door, said I would have to choose. If I...
Yeah! 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 Oh my God, big one! Oh yeah!
Get home. Right now I'm on this lake shore and I'm sitting in the...
Oh, it's on record.
Ah!
It's on record. Go get him.
Through that door tonight. Yeah, I'm gonna...
Oh my God! Oh! Oh my God! Oh my God! I'm going bad! 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 Woo! Yeah, that's right over there. That's right. Oh, dang.
Dance. if I hurry, I could beg her to stay. That water's right and the weather's perfect. No telling what I might catch today. So I'm...
Snap it, come on.
I feel bad, he says.
Wait till your mother sees this one.
I did one.
You little walleye snapper.
I did it, too.
Hey, come on.
We're out in the outdoors.
I can't do this in Illinois every day.
No.
Do this in Illinois for real.
You guys don't do that for school, do you?
You guys are bad.
Gone bad.
Look at that. Isn't that pretty?
Yeah. Got a movie going here.
Try to dry your hands.
Bring them over.
I'm not cracking any more than that.
You feel bad when you eat
them? Yeah.
Hey, isn't it pretty?
Folks lined up here like
yeah,
that?
He says I do.
Well, I love her, but I love the fish. I spend all day out on this lake, and hell is all I catch. But today she met me at the door, said I would have to choose. If I hit that fishing hole today, she'd be packing all her things and she be gone by noon. Well, I'm gonna miss her when I get home. Right now I'm on this lake shore and I'm sitting in the sun. I'm sure when I walk through that door tonight, yeah, I'm gonna miss her. Oh, looky there, I've got a bite. All right.
Fish went too big. We talk about this classic has to be a test. How about it coming down to Skeet Reese and Michael Iaconelli, two Toyota Tundra Bassmaster Anglers of the Year from consecutive years.
God. 5-pounder. There's a big one. It's coming over. He's still on there. He's still on there. He's coming out. It's a big one. Oh, God! Oh, God! Please! Please! God, please! Yeah! Six pounder!
Michael Iaconelli, we see him.
Once again, cable TV slam dunks you. Only cable could take the most sedate sport in the world, fishing, and turn it into an adrenaline rush. Ladies and gentlemen, I give you Mike Iaconelli. And as you watch this man, remember, this guy is a fisherman.
Yeah! Yeah! Yeah!
To eat it. You add to that that little red laser as an extra trigger and you're going to catch a lot of big bass. Crashing a crankbait is one of the hottest techniques on the trail today.
Giant! 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 So ripping that crankbait.
And that's the deal right there. Everybody thinks crankbaits are for open water. If you rip these crankbaits through the bushes, use the braided line, that's the lighted laser lure, that's the kind of bite you can trigger. You don't have to throw a crankbait in open water, it's not just for open water. Throw it in the crap, rip it out, rip in a crankbait.
Yeah! Look at that thing! God, monster!
On the edge, if you want to catch monster fish, fish a snake. Big worms.
Big one! Oh, big one. Oh, God. Uh-oh. Oh, God! Oh! Oh! Ah! Ah!
Look in that fish's mouth. Look how far down that worm is. I'm gonna tell you, don't be.
Your last fish of the day. We see one more strike, one more fish for Michael Iaconelli. Would it be enough to win this classic? Boy, this was the moment of truth right here.
There he goes. It's a giant.
Let's go! Put that camera down! Put it down! Yeah! Put that camera down, let's go! Let's go. God, thank you, Lord. Never give up! Never give up! Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Put that camera down. Let's go. Let's go, let's go, let's go.
Classic Iaconelli stuff, really just a replay of 2003 when he caught what he thought and rightly thought was a winning fish back then here in the state of Louisiana.
Unbelievable final moments of fishing for Mike Iaconelli. Unbelievable final moments of fishing for Mike Iaconelli and a phenomenal day for you. Were you worried for the last 2 hours?
Ah! Yeah! 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 I'm bad! I'm bad! Bad!
Your last fish of the day. We see one more strike, one more fish for Michael Iaconelli. Would it be enough to win this classic? Boy, this was the moment of truth right here.
There he goes. It's a giant.
Let's go! Put that camera down! Put it down! Yeah! Put that camera down, let's go! Let's go. God, thank you, Lord. Never give up! Never give up! Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Put that camera down. Let's go. Let's go, let's go, let's go.
Just classic Iaconelli stuff. Really just a replay of 2003 when he caught what he thought and rightly thought was a winning fish back then here in the state of Louisiana.
Unbelievable final moments of fishing for Mike Iaconelli. Unbelievable final moments of fishing for Mike Iaconelli, and a phenomenal day for you. Were you worried for the last 2 hours? Tommy, one of the best moments of the year has got to be Mike Iaconelli literally jumping in the water. Probably one of the most athletic moves ever.
Let's keep it. Nice catch. That's amazing.
Let's look at this one more time. Super athletic move, and here's the thing to keep in mind. For this to be legal, he's got to keep his hands on the boat, and that he does, never leaves the boat. And Iaconelli back in legally, and he saves one of those precious fish from Table Rock.
Big one! Big one! Oh my God! This is a giant. Gonna be calling something. This is a giant. Oh my God. Oh my God. Oh my God. It's the winning fish. No! No! Woo! Never give up! Never give up! I can't believe it. Oh my God, we were just talking about it.
Folks at home, that one's for you, baby.
Woo! Yeah! Yeah! Oh my God, I love it. Thank you, Lord. Oh my God.
I just can't say enough about the enthusiasm for this boy.
Chipped away at it. Right now we have him unofficially about 3 pounds behind Biffle, and we have to tell you, at this point we've had a little bit of technical difficulties. His mic is not where it ought to be, and it's not picking up all the sound, so we're just going to have to bear with him through this fish catch.
Oh God, oh God! Mike! Look at that!
What is wrong with that guy?
But of course, he needs no Mike. We should have known that, Michael Iaconelli. How many times have we seen that? This guy was 3 pounds behind Biffle. Now we unofficially have him at 3 ounces behind Biffle. That is a huge move on this final championship day on Wheeler Lake. Never give up. Never give up, indeed.
I don't need no Mike.
You know, if you think fishing's luck, you're wrong. Fishing's an art. If you want to master your art, think outside the box and fish on the edge.
Ah! Oh my God!
Fishing on the Edge is presented by Castrol Edge. Think with your dipstick. Nothing offers better wear protection.
You know, everybody's heard of the finesse technique called drop shotting. Well, you know what? There's another variation of that called power shotting. It's the same basic setup, a hook in line, a leader and a weight on the bottom, except in power shotting, everything's heavy duty. We're talking about 20-pound, 25-pound fluorocarbon line, a big stout 3 or 4-aught hook, and a bigger tungsten weight, a 3/8 or even a 1/2 ounce tungsten weight. And the nice thing about power shotting, we've got heavy line, we've got this heavy tackle, we could throw it right in the middle of the cover. I'm talking about bushes, trees, under docks, around rocks. Don't be scared to throw it around the heaviest stuff you can get. Unlike that little 6-pound line and spinning rod, if you throw this around heavy cover, you're gonna land those big fish. Throw it in there, let that weight hit the bottom, and shake your rod tip. When you get that bite, set the hook. I wanna guarantee you that drop shotting is a good technique. Power shotting is an even better technique.